I like OpenGL, and I like Rust. Huh. Let's create a window with SDL2, which will display an OpenGL context using Rust. Create a new cargo project. The Rust crate to manage raw OpenGL is GL, and the SDL2 crate is the one we need for the window. The SDL2 crate provides bindings for the original SDL2 library written in C. So, to link the bindings, you will need a C compiler like Lang or GCC, and you will need to specify linking flags to that compiler. Here on Windows, the simplest thing to do is to use their bundled feature to automatically build SDL2 from source, compile it, and link it dynamically. Let's write SDL code in a module so we can reuse it more easily for future projects. We'll be wrapping what we need to keep in a struct, win_sdl. That is to say, the initialized SDL context SDL, the SDL window, and the SDL event handler called event pump. Even if we don't use some of these fields, especially SDL, this will prevent them from going out of scope, which would destroy them at the end of the constructor method before actually using SDL. Speaking of a constructor method, ours will accept width and height arguments to properly size the window, and will return an instance of our struct. Inside here, we'll be initializing everything related to SDL. Initialize the context, build a window, and get its event pump. You can customize the window, its name, size, that's where our parameters are used, whether it is resizable, etc. We are now ready to spawn a blank window. Go back to main.rs and use the constructor. Give it the width and height you want the window to have. This would simply open and close the window instantly, so add an infinite loop to keep the window alive, and also check for events to allow the user to close the window. Cargo run. And there it is, a blank window that can be closed. Now, let's set up OpenGL. In order to specify the OpenGL attributes we want, call GL attribute. This way, we can specify the OpenGL version and profile we want. In this case, I chose version 3.3 as it is the latest version which is widely supported, and the core profile will be enough. We'll need to call .opengl just before building the window so that it is ready to welcome an OpenGL context. Then create this OpenGL context through SDL and load the necessary function pointers. Add GL context and GL to the fields of our struct to keep them in scope for the main function. You can also set the swap interval to vsync, which will automatically limit the frame rate of OpenGL to the refresh rate of the monitor it is on. This will avoid rendering thousands of useless frames every second. Back again to main.rs. Let's try to clear the window in red using OpenGL to see if we've successfully initialized and linked those. Use GL clear color to set the clearing color to red, and GL clear to fill our window in that color. Those are unsafe operations in Rust, so we need to put them in an unsafe block, which implies that we need to pay attention to potentially unfreed memory. In this case, there shouldn't be any problem as we don't allocate new memory. Then call GL swap window every frame to update what's displayed. We successfully get a red window. To check it didn't render only one frame, we can change the color using the time that elapsed since we started rendering. Use the sign of time and get a varying value between -1 and 1. Add 1 to it and divide the result by 2 to get a correct red value between 0 and 1. And here is our animation. The next two videos will probably be about OpenGL in Rust. Tell me if you think a full series would be interesting and if you have ideas on a specific format. I'm thinking of more project-oriented videos when I'll have covered the essentials that will go through everything needed in a small or larger project with a final goal in mind, rather than documenting.